Anxiety disorders affect nearly 20% of adults in North America. That's about 40 million people. When we're feeling anxious or stressed, sometimes it just feels good to go home and indulge in some well-deserved vices. We've all planted our butts in our couches and binge-watched our favorite shows while eating pizza. But as tempting as that sounds, is it really the best thing for us? And as it turns out, some of our guilty pleasures may be agitating our anxiety instead of reducing it. Here are 8 everyday habits that may be stressing you out more than you know. Number 1. Being a couch potato. When you spend all day huddled up in bed or on your sofa, you give up the chance to decrease your tension, improve your sleep, and stabilize your mood. Yes, your daily activeness has a direct effect on your mood. Regular exercise is important in maintaining your mental health because it reduces stress. Just 10 minutes of exercise a day can improve your alertness and concentration. Number 2. Do you skip meals because you're too busy being out and about? You're only causing your body stress. When you don't have enough to eat, your blood sugar levels take a dive, making you feel anxious, sluggish, and irritated. Want to feel calm and happy? Eat foods like berries, spinach, and fish. All these foods and their nutrients work toward the elevation of mood and the warding off of depression. Number 4. Coffee addiction. Caffeine is no friend to anyone who is prone to anxiety. Caffeine stimulates our fight-or-flight response centers, mimicking our physiological reactions to dangerous or scary situations. This makes us feel alert and energized. But this simulation also means we have to deal with fight-or-flight symptoms, increased heart rate, sweaty palms, an upset stomach, and shaky hands. A good alternative that can wake us up in the morning is a cold glass of water with lemon or cucumber. Or both, if you're feeling festive. Number 5. Scrolling through social media. It's a common habit to scroll through Instagram or Facebook in our free time. But being on social media can take time away from other more important things, like being present at work or getting tasks done. The realization that you spent 20 minutes looking at your Instagram feed can lead to regret and anxiety for not using your time more productively. Being able to look at the best parts of other people's lives online can often make us feel jealous and upset about our own lives. Unplug for a while. Focus on people in front of you and spend time with friends and loved ones. Those are the kinds of interactions that help you feel happy. Number 6. You don't get sleep. You need at least 7 hours of sleep in order to feel healthy and energized in the day. Anything less and you will feel the effects of sleep deprivation. These effects include heightened stress, mood destabilization, poor cognitive functioning, and lowered immune system. Sleep deprivation can also cause anticipatory anxiety, which is the anxiety you feel right before events like heading into work, having to speak publicly, or taking a test. Are you a habitual pre-sleep computer or phone user? These overstimulating gadgets are actually preventing your brain from winding down. Try reading a book before bed, or better yet, pre-sleep breathing meditation. Number 7. Spending too much time alone. This might not seem productive for someone who suffers from anxiety, but spending time with other people can actually help to alleviate symptoms of anxiety. Spending time with supportive friends and developing healthy, positive attachments can help to improve social functioning and increase happiness. Alone time is important every once in a while, especially for all of you introverts out there, but it's just as important to get out there and to see your friends. Number 8. Listening to moody music. Yes, sad songs can affect your mood. The emotion and effect of the songs you listen to have direct effects on your current emotions. If you're already feeling anxious or sad, it's probably not in your best interest to play your breakup playlist on repeat. That sad tune will exacerbate the sadness and anxiety you may already be feeling. The next time you're feeling sad or anxious, listen to something happy. Make a playlist full of calming or positive music that will help you find your happy place. Now remember, these habits are not surefire anxiety triggers for everyone. Doing any of these things will not guarantee a bout of anxiety, but they will increase your chances of it. What do you think? Any anxiety-inducing habits you've been guilty of? Are there any habits you know of that should have made it on the list? Let us at Psych2Go know in the comments section down below. Want to read more about the topic? Visit psych2go.net using the link down below to view the original article. And don't forget to subscribe for updates on new videos.